Welcome back to our second part of our tutorial. Last time we learned how to create a table. In this tutorial, we want to learn how to create a form. Forms are very good in terms of entering data, and it helps you to enter data more rapidly and also reduce errors. Using table to enter data may sometimes create a lot of errors, so we prefer to create forms that will help you or serve as user interface to enter data into the table. So before we start, let us now launch our Microsoft Access. Then we use our table that we created the last time to create the form. So click on your Access. When it opens, at your left side you see recent items that are there. That is what I have done so far. Our database name was Student Management System, so I'll click on it for it to open. Alright, so when it opens, what you see is what your access interface. Our table name is somewhere at the left side. If I double click on it, I'll see this. Alright, so once it opens, you will see recent items or recent documents. Remember that we use Student Management System as our database name. So I'll click on it for it to open. Then you will see our tables in there that need to help us to create our forms. So I'll click on the database name. Once it opens, you will see the name of the table at your left side. And also, there is an option here, a warning option here, that tells you that some active content has been disabled. Click for more details. Anytime you open Access Database and you see this thing over here, please click on it to enable it. If not, you cannot work with some of the things over here. So kindly click on it. Alright, so once you click on it, then double click on your table and your table to come. So this is a table that we created the last time when we are learning tables. Now remember, in table we learned two views, the design view and the data sheet view. Currently we are the data sheet view because this side helps you to enter data. The data sheet view helps you to what? Enter data. And if you want to add a new attribute or a new field name here to the next one here, you have to go back to where a design view like this to enter a new field name or attribute here. Okay, so this is what we did last week. Now you want to learn how to create a form, but before you create a form, make sure that your table is open in a data sheet view. I'm saying that before you create a form, make sure that your table is open in a data sheet view. In a data sheet view, if your table is open in a design view, that form cannot be created. Let me show you example. Now I want to create a form while the table is where at a design view. So I'll go to create, then locate a form. Now for forms, we have three different types, or more than three different types of forms as we see here. But I want to learn a simple way. So you click on the first one, form. As you see, human being or a picture on it, this way, called form. I click on it. Now this is the error I'm going to see. And this error tells me that it cannot find any table in a data sheet view, as you see here. So you have to open the table in the datasheet view before you can create the form. So I'll click on OK going to open my table in datasheet view. So I'll go right click on this table here, this tab, right click on it, then go to datasheet view. Then at this part now, I can now create my form. So how do I create my form? Click on the form icon at the top here, or go to create the form at form icon. You see it here. Remember that when you go to create, we have the three objects here. We have the tables, we have the queries, we have the forms. Even this, even four, and a report. That's what you are going to treat. So click on form once. As soon as you click on form, you see a well designed form here that will help you to enter data. So you see it, as I click, it's highlighted round form. You can see it here, form. Now when it comes to form, as the way we saw it in table, form has three views that we have to learn over here. Now once you create form, automatically you see a new tab added to what the already existing tab. So you see design, arrange, and form. If I click on the table tab here, that thing will go away, or that new tab will go away. It means that currently I'm at where? The table. So I'll see filled tables to filled one, or fields and table. But if I click on the form over here, the form tab, then I'll see a new tab added to the already existing tab, that is design, arrange, and form. So now you've created what? Our form. Now that you've created your form, or you have your form, we have to save the form. Currently, the form was created from the table. So you realize that at the top here, the form is taking the table name as TBL student. It's not supposed to be like that. We have to use the form prefix to save this form. When it's table, it is called TBL. When it's form, it is called FRM. That's the prefix that you're going to use. So FRM student. So you have to save the form so that the name will come as part of the object here, because currently we see only the table at this object, or this object place here. So right click on the tab here, and you see the three types of form view. There are form view, layout view, and design view. There are the three types of things that you have to learn as form. So now click on save. Then to ask you, what name do you want to save your form? Just edit this part and type FRM student. That is our form name, and click OK. Once you click OK, the form name will be saved automatically at the left side. So you have a table, TBL student, and a form this. You can create more tables and it will come here. And more forms will also come here. Alright. Now that we're able to create our form, now let us try and do some editing on the form. Now currently we have to know which view, or the view that we are in now. So how do you do that? It's either you right click on the tab here to know the view that you are in currently. At the moment you can see that you are the layout view, because you see a rectangular box around it. Now the form view and design view. Alright, another way is that once you're in the form, at the left side here you can see a view. When you click on it, to give you the same option, it tells you where you are now. So currently at where? Layout view. Now at layout view, this is where you can do changes or edit your form. So let's see how to edit or make changes to our form at layout view. Now these names were picked from the table. We don't want to use this name anymore. We want to use actually the correct names, so that people can see or see the actual names of this form. You also have to change the TBL student here, because this time this is not a table. It's what? A form. So let's try and do some editing on this form. Now, the first thing we want to do is change the title over here as our form name. So click on it like this. Once you click on it, you see a yellow box, a rectangular box around it. It tells you that now you want to apply some changes to this particular form. So double click on the form. Then you see the cursor blinking inside the control or inside the form name. Now rename the form name as student form or student registration form. Once you are done, just click outside the rectangular box for it to save. Good. So now the name is our student registration form, as you can see here. Let's try and do some modification. Let's try and bold it, center it, and change the font style or size. So click on this one. Once you click on this one, you see the font style or text formatting at your right side here. Bold it as you want it to bold, center it, be in the middle, or you can even change the color if you want. You can add color to it or change the text color if you want. Whatever you do will be applied to the form, as you see. Now we are the layout view. That is why you can able to do all those things here. So at layout view, you can edit the form the way you want it to be. So for instance, this form here is too long. I can just close it small. Just bring the cursor or the mouse pointer at the tip edge here to see this arrow sign with two double arrow sign like this. Then click on it, then drag it to your left to close it small, at least the form to look a little bit presentable. Also, you can now change or edit all these names here. For instance, I can double click this one and remove the dash there, then make it a student or index number. This one too, I can double click on it and change it. Now DOB, sometimes people will not understand, so let's try and write the full name there. So you have date of birth. Then pics, we can also write picture of student or picture. With this, you can also bold all this side here. So click on this, bold it, click on this one, bold it, or hold your control key, then click on each of it whilst you still hold the control key, then click on bold to bold everything at once. So you can see our form is now looking a bit nice. There's also a logo here. If you have any logo, you can just place it or put a logo here. Once you click on the logo or this box here as a logo, okay, what you can do is that just locate design. At design, you can see logo. Click on it. Then if you have any picture or logo we have for your company, you can just click on one of them, put it there, then you can have your logo picture there as the way you want it to be. So that's how you create a form or trying to edit a form using what we call the form layout view to edit the options of the form. Alright, now so we've done a little on the form layout view. Now let's go and see how to enter or add controls to the form, controls or command to the form. You have to learn how to enter controls or command to the form. Unlike other form, you see save, next, close, search. With this form, we don't have any commands on the form. So if you want to enter any records, it's going to be difficult. So why don't you create a command or buttons on the phone called navigation, so that you help us to input data or edit data to the form to be sent to the table. So how do we do that? Okay, now since we are done with the form layout view, let's go and also learn how to use the form design view. The layout view helps you to edit or make changes to your form background. You can even insert a picture at the background over here. If you have any picture, just go to insert, then you see browse the picture to be your form background as you want it to be. Alright, so now let's go to our design view. So right click on this tab, go to where design view. Now our design view, this is what you are going to see. We have what we call the form header, details, and form footer. Now we want to put controls inside the form. Controls are commands that we place on the form for it to respond. So how do we put commands inside the form? Before we do that, we have to create a space where we want the control to come. Now we have the form footer here that has closed all the attributes on the form. So we have to get a space in between somewhere here to put the controls there. How do you do that? Now put your cursor somewhere here. When it change toward this plus sign, click on it, then drag it down as the way it is moving, so that the form footer will come down, so I can get some space over here to put your controls or command there. You can also bring it somewhere here to open the form platform, so I can have enough space to put enough things there. So let me open it a little bit wider. Bring it down here. When you change the plus sign, click on it, then drag it down small. Okay, so now I've gotten enough space to put my controls there. How do I put my controls there? Now we are at where? We are the design view of the form. So at the top there, you see design, you see arrange and format. Because we are in design view, we have to use a tab on the form design tool as the word design. So click on the design. When click on the design, you see what you call controls, the commands that we want to place on the form called controls. Controls. Now with this part here of this study here, we want to learn how to create a button control, buttons. And buttons give us the option or the commands to navigate through the forms. So let's learn how to create buttons. Now go to controls, locate buttons as this way. You see buttons here, it has some kind of cross on it. Cross, click on the button. Once you click on it, you see it being highlighted over here. It means you click on the button. When you bring your mouse pointer on the platform or the form platform, you see it as plus sign holding what, a button. It means that you have to click somewhere and drag or draw the space or the width of your button that you want. So I'll click on this side, click without leaving your hands or removing your hands from the mouse button. Click like this, then drag somewhere, then release your hands from it. Once you release your hands from it, you will see a box, mini box open, or wizard being open. At the wizard, we have what we call categories of options that can be applied to the form. We have a record navigation, record operation, form operation, report operation, application, miscellaneous. For this tutorial, we want to learn or use only record navigation and record operation. So now let's see how to do it. Now the first thing we want to do is to pick some of these record operations here I mean record navigations here to apply to our button. So the first one we want to look is to use what we called go to first record. Go to first record. And this one will jump the records to the first record. So if you are somewhere in the middle of the record and want to go to the first record, it will go. If you are somewhere the last record and want to go to the first record, the system will take you to the first record. So go to the first record. So I'll click on it, click on next, then I'll select the name test as so that the name will be written on the button instead of command 23 or what I have here. You can have any command. I want the name to be applied on the command, so I'll click on next, then click on finish. Once you do that, you see first record here. Then try to click somewhere here, the edges here, then open it, make it very nice. If you still want to redesign the button, click on it like this. You see a yellow box around it called highlighting. Then drag it at anywhere you want. Open it, close it. You can also click like this. When it become a plus sign like this, you can click on it and drag it, move it to wherever you want to move it. Or like this to open it small. Whatever I want to do to your button, you can do it there. Now let's go back again and put in additional button. So I'll go back here, button, click on it. I'll see the plus sign of the button, click and drag. Remove your hand, it will come. Then now let's select, go to the last record. So select this one from record navigation, click on next, click on test, click on next, and click on finish. So last record. Let me try to resize it to be the same size as the first record. Yes. Okay. Now let me add more. So go back again, draw record. Now go to the next record. This time if I record one, it goes to record two. So let me use go to the next record. Select next record, go to next, and finish. Then resize it. Last one, click on the record somewhere at the form. You come, click on the previous record, click on next, click on the test, click on the next, then click on finish. So I have this here. So I resize it more. Okay, the same thing to this one, same thing to this one, resize it more. All right, so I'll go to the first record, last record, next record, and previous record. What if I want to add a new record to the system? So you have to go and find a command button that will help us to add a new record to the system. So let me go back there, button. Click on this button, come and draw it. Then if I want to add a new record, I will not find it at record navigation. I have to go to record operation. So add a new record. You can see it is already highlighted, add a new record as this one. So click on next, click on add a new record, click on next, click on finish. Like this. So you have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 controls or commands. You can add more. depend on what you want to do. So try and explore more to add more. You have save, you have search, you have whole lot. For instance, if you want to search a record, you can click on a button and look for a search record. When you click on it and you draw mistakenly, then the form closes like this. Just click on delete key on the keyboard to remove it. Now we've done our controls on our form. We can also bold it if you want to format it so that the control names will be nice. So highlight it, go to form, format, bold, click on this one, or at the same time go to bold, or you can also change the font size of the name, the ratings. Good. So we are still at where design view. Once you are done with these controls, let's go and see how it works. So now right click on the form and go to layout view to see how it looks like over here. So we have the next first record, last record, next record, previous record, and add new record. The same as add new student to the system or add new student. We can edit this one, double click on it. When you see the cursor blinking, continue to add new student instead of saying add new record. Add new student like this. Click somewhere, then it should be saved. Okay, so we've learned how to create our form now. Now, how do you test the form? We are able to understand the layout view that is used to what? Edit or format the form. If you want to bold it, if you want to change items over here, if you want to put a background picture, if you want to color all those things, this names attribute here, if you want to make changes, you have to use the layout view. Then the design view here, when you go there, helps you to put controls or buttons on the form. Controls, if you go to design view, you go to your design, locate the controls, any control I want to use, the button that you want to use, you can still use any of them. Then you draw or design on your form. Now the form becomes ready when you go to what they call the form view. At the form view, when you click on it, it means that now the form is ready to test or is now in operation. So at form view, you can't do any changes or editing here. This is where you have to enter your data or your records or test your system whether it's working. So at form view, you check whether what your system is working. So at layout view here, you do or apply editing to the form. At design view, you add controls or buttons or add more things to the form. At form view, tell that the form is ready for you to use. So now let us see if our form is working or the controls are working. Good. Now before we do that, let us close our table as you've seen over here. The table, click on the table, right click on the table like this and click on close. So now we have only the form platform or the form tab as here. Let's see whether our navigations are working, our buttons are working. So go to the next record. You see the names are changing because I'm going to the next name. Next name, it is changing. Next record name, it is changing. Next record, just change. Next record, just change. If you want to go to previous record, click on the previous record, just change. Previous record, just change. Previous record, just change. If you want to go to the first record, click on the first record like this. Take me to the very first record, the very first record. The last record, take me to the very last record over here. Good. So you realize that once whilst you are clicking next record like this or previous record here, okay, now the total records is being shown here. So I have only seven records over here. Currently I'm on a sixth record, that's why you see 6 of 7 here. When I go to next record here, it means I'm on the 7th or 7th record, so it will not go again. Next one will be 00 records. When I come to the last record here, it's taking me to the last record. The first record here, take me to the first record here, as you can see here. Good. Now I want to add new records in our form now. What about add here to send to the table? Because creating or adding data to the table sometimes become very difficult. Very difficult. I'm saying that putting data to the table or entry data to the table sometimes become very difficult. So the form will help you to enter your data to the table without facing any challenges. So for instance, assume that I go back to the table and I want to enter somebody's record. If I don't take care, my mind is somewhere here, but the cursor can move somewhere and go and edit somebody's record. So it is very bad to enter records through the table. That is why you've designed a form. Whatever you put inside the form here will be sent to the table for you to see. So now let's close our table. Then let's enter our data. Remember that you can only enter data at your form view. Remember this, at your form view. Layout view help you to what? Design or edit your form. Design will help you to put your controls on the form. So now let us try and see. I want to add a new record. So I click on add new student. So add new student now. You realize that all the records here is empty because I want to add a new student to the system. So enter a new index number. Name Kwesi Abua J. Gender, click on the drop down list. Male, age 32. Level, click on level to come here, 300. Date of birth, as I click on it, you see the date packer as here. You can just click on any date or you can just edit your date that you want, 1998 or 1988. Then you have the picture. Click on the picture. Once you click on the picture, you see this pin icon called manage attachment or attachment icon. Click on it like this, then it open. You can now add your picture to that particular student. So I click on one here, it will come here. I say okay, the picture will come. I'm done with Kwesi Abuaji. Let me add another person. Name Mary Akusia Dankwa. Gender female, age 22, level 200, date of birth, click any data you want. Picture, if I have a picture, click on a picture, I will see this 10 file manager icon here. Click on it to ask me where the picture is. Select any picture. Now I don't have any female picture on my laptop, so let me just use the male picture. Then add or click OK. Then the picture will come here. Then you say add new student again to be sent to the table. Hey, we forgot to create a save record. So let's go back to our design view and create a button called save, so that whatever we enter, it will save it for us. So right click on the form here, tab, go to design view. Then let's go and create a save button. Let me just open our forms more. Click on it and open it some more. Go back to the button. Come and draw it here. Now let's locate record operation. Let's locate save records. So it's here, save records. Click on next. Click on save record, next, and finish. So now I have a save record. Open it very nicely. Then go to the format, make bold. Make the text 12 like this. So I've done. So go right click or go back to your form view to check whether it's there. Yes, I have it here. So whatever I enter, click on just save then it will be saved into the system for you. Well, this is how to create a simple form for this tutorial. You can create more complex form, but keep on practicing how to create more forms. Add more controls to the form, add more design to the form. Just browse through the access tools so that you can know or learn much things inside the application. If you'd like to end the tutorial, do what you practice, and I'll give an assignment following this tutorial. Thank you and have a nice day.